Myself, I am Gunakar, Assistant Professor of Zoology, Government Degree College, Siddipet, Telangana State. Today, we shall discuss parental care in amphibia. The amphibians are the first vertebrates to come to the land, to invade to the land, that is, from the water, from the aquatic habitat to the terrestrial habitat. They had to face many problems initially, hence, they developed various ways to overcome the obstacles. So naturally, greatest importance was given to the perpetuation of race so that they can win the struggle on the harsh terrestrial life. So the reproductive mechanism has undergone extensive modification, and perpetuation of race can be maintained either by overproduction of eggs or by caring of small number of eggs. Now, what is parental care? Looking after the eggs or the young or the juveniles until they are independent to defend from predators is known as parental care. Or parental care is a modification in the parents to take care of this offspring so that with a meager number of eggs the continuation of race can be maintained. It is very important factor for survival. Very number of animals exhibit a great diversity in caring for their eggs and young during their development. Lower animals like invertebrates, they produce many number of eggs and they don't have to take care of their juveniles or eggs during the development. But especially the higher animals like vertebrates, where the number of eggs produced by the parents is very less, they had to take care of those eggs. That's why parental care has more developed in the case of vertebrates when compared to invertebrates. Perhaps no group shows more diversity than do the amphibians, especially those living in tropical regions. And within the amphibians, anurans show much greater diversity than urodils and apodans. And let us now look at the methods of parental care in the amphibians. Parental care methods are generally fall into two main types. Number one, protection by nests, nurseries or shelters. That means amphibians evolved various methods to give protection to eggs and juveniles and larvae from the predators. And number two, direct caring by the parents. The amphibians adopted various ways to take care of their eggs, larvae or young ones so that they can be protected from the predators. First method, protection by nests, nurseries or shelters. In this method, there are various ways by which the parents belonging to amphibians, they protect their eggs and juveniles by constructing nests, nurseries or shelters. So the first one is selection of the site. Many amphibians lay eggs in protected moist microhabitats on land. Many tropical frogs and toads lay eggs on land near water. Many tree frogs lay their eggs not on land but on leaves and branches overhanging the water. Like for example, species like Philomedusa, Hylodes, they deposit the spawn on trees, especially rhacophores. That means these Philomedusa and Hylodes, they glue the eggs to leaves and branches over the hanging water. And whereas Rhacophorus malabaricus and Chiromantis of Africa, they deposit the spawn on trees, that means especially the aquatic trees. Tadpoles on hatching drop into water beneath to complete the metamorphosis. Then number two, second method in protection by nests, nurseries or shelters, defending eggs or territories. In this, parents maintain territories and attack small intruders to protect the eggs. Males of green frag like Rana Clamitans and other species maintain territories and attack small intruders to defend eggs. In Mantophryne robusta, male sits over and holds with hand the elastic gelatinous envelope containing eggs. Some tree frogs sit beside the eggs or rest on top of them also. So you can see the frog sitting near the eggs. And here also, the frog sitting near the eggs, especially this, they laid on the leaf. Now the third method, is the direct development in some terrestrial or tree frogs such as the Hyla nebulosa, Artholeptes, Hylodes and red-backed salamander, Plethodon cinereus. The eggs hatch directly into little frogs, thus avoiding larval mortality. So you can see this figure where the eggs hatch directly into little frogs. They avoid larval mortality also, thus they are protected much. Now the fourth is forming foam nests. Many amphibians convert large amount of mucus secretions into nests for their young. Like for example, Japanese tree frog Rhacophorus schlegeli, the mating couple digs a hole or tunnel into which eggs are left in frothy mass. During rains, hatching tadpoles wash down into the pond or nearby river for further development. Next type is mud nests. Construction of mud nests. Hyla faber, a Brazilian tree frog, where male frog digs a small hole in the mud for developing eggs in shallow water, and female lays her eggs in this mud constructed or nest. And tadpoles, when they hatch within this safe barrier, they come out and they metamorphose to the adults safely. Next method is tree nests. Especially the South American tree frog Phyllomedusa hypochondrales, it lays eggs in a folded leaf nest with margins glued together by a cloacal secretion. When tadpoles hatch, they fall straight into the water below. You can see the folded leaf whose margins are glued together by its cloacal secretions. Next one is gelatinous bags. The Salamandrella kieserlingi, a small aquatic salamander which is not an anuran, deposits 50 to 60 eggs in a gelatinous bag which is attached to aquatic plants. Now these are the seven methods that are where eggs and juveniles are protected by constructing nests, nurseries or shelters. Now the second method, where the parents care for their young and juveniles, is direct caring by parents. In this, there are again various methods are there. Number one, coiling around eggs. There are many amphibians like Amphiuma, which is commonly called Congo eel, and certain Sicilians, that is blind snakes, like Ichthyophis and Hypogeophis. The female lays large eggs in burrows in damp soil and carefully guards them by coiling her body around them until they hatch. Now you can see here. So here, Ichthyophis, how the body is coiled around the eggs here. And you can see this also. Here you can see the female salamander, Plethodon, also protecting the eggs, coiling around the eggs. So directly they care for the eggs. Now in this direct caring by parents, the second way is transferring tadpoles in water. Some species deposit their eggs on ground, where these eggs, when they hatch out, tadpoles attach to the back of one of their parents with their sucker like mouth and transported to water. Example, you can see the Phyllobetis dendrobetis, you can see where here the tadpoles are attached to the back of the parent. Easily you can see these are the tadpoles, and the directly parents can carry these tadpoles into the surrounding water bodies. Third method in this direct caring by parents is eggs glued to body. Many amphibians carry the eggs glued to their body. Like for example, Rhacophorus reticulatus, Alytes obstetricans, which is commonly called midwife toad, where the males carry the eggs which are glued to the body. You can see this is the Aletes obstetricans, midwife toad, and various other frogs where the eggs are glued to their bodies. And they carry these eggs directly to the water bodies, and until they hatch out, they care for them. Next, fourth method is eggs in back pouches. In this way, in this method, female carries the eggs on her back, either in an open depressions or a closed pouch or in individual pockets. The eggs develop into miniature frogs before they leave mother's back. Example, one group of tree frogs called marsupial frogs or toads, the female carries the eggs on her back either in an open oval depression, a closed pouch, or in individual pockets. So you can see here, female with eggs in the incipient dorsal brood pouch. Here you can see on the back of the females. So here marsupial frogs and toads, Cryptobranchus evansi, Nototrima, Pipa, Pipa, the Suriname toad. So this is especially the Suriname toad. This is the Suriname toad. The next method is organs, some of the organs working as brooding pouches. See, in this method, in some of the fishes, vocal sacs, they act as brood pouches. Example, Rhinoderma darwini, Darwin's frog. In some other frog, buccal cavity working as a brood pouch, where example is African tree frog Hylambetes breviceps. And in some fishes, in some frogs, stomach as brood pouch. Stomach is functioning as brood pouch, where Rheobatrachus silus, which is an Australian frog. Now you can see here the where vocal cords functions as the brood pouches, which is Darwin's frog. And here the gastric cavity, that means stomach, functions as a brood pouch in Australian frog. So after growth, they will come out of the frog's mouth, and then they grow in the water, they metamorphose in. Now coming to the next method, viviparous. Animals which lay the eggs are called as oviparous, whereas the animals which give direct birth to the young ones are called as the viviparous. And some of the animals which are said to be ovoviviparous, where the eggs are laid, and but that eggs are laid not outside of the body, but they are retained in the inside, and when they hatch out, the hatchlings will come out. Hatchlings will grow inside the body, and then the fully grown young ones will be delivered out of the body. And this type of method is called as ovoviviparous method, and where they retain eggs in the oviducts or in some of the parts of the females, and again after they give birth to the living young. So especially this viviparity is widespread in the order Gymnophiana. For example, three or four families have this mode of reproduction. Common examples are Typhlonectis, Dermophis, etc. So the European salamander, you can see the Salamandra, it produces 20 or more small young, while the Alpine Salamandra atra gives birth to one or two fully developed young ones. Directly you can see here the salamander giving birth to the young ones directly. So this is called viviparity. So by taking care of these young ones, especially the juvenile stages, the parental care is more developed in the case of amphibians, which are invaded into the land for the first time among the vertebrates. Thank you.